How are you?
Good morning. I hope all of you had a great 9 o'clock session. I sure did. Welcome to the 10 o'clock session. We have Stu Karoff and the Penguin Corps for you. Today they will be talking about open source in schools. And the stage is yours. Take it away.
Okay.
Hello. I'm Dominic. Welcome to Open Source Belongs in School. Let's put it there. In the next 45 minutes, you will hear our story about how we revolutionized tech at our school with open source software and how you can too. Please join us in the Penguin Corps Pledge. What are we trying to do?
Change the world!
How do you change the world?
Be crazy enough to think you can!
Penguin Corps Agenda. Leader calls meeting to order. Stu Karoff, a little bit of history. Michael A., what we do. Kat, we value diversity. Jaden, open source and the pandemic. Ethan, why do we have an open source club? Jason, you can do it too. Here's how. Q&A. Now please welcome Mr. Stu Karoff.
Good morning. This is our first visit to Open Source North. Thanks for coming. The first computer I ever saw was an Apple II at my elementary school. I'm dating myself now, but it was the late 70s. It didn't even belong to the school. It belonged to the school district. And each school in the district would get to borrow it for a few weeks. The individual experience for any kid at my school with that machine was pretty brief. And nobody had a computer in their home, way out of reach for most families. Things were a little better in the 80s when my high school had a computer lab of Apple IIs, but computers were still too expensive for most families like mine. The late 90s and early 2000s brought a lot of changes with the explosion of the internet and affordability of computers. My wife and I would pick up used computers from people who were upgrading, and we saved up to buy our first computer in 2002. I was starting back to school to get my teacher's license, and it took all the money we had at the time just to get the computer. We had nothing left over to get Microsoft Office, and I was going to need software for school. No problem, I thought. There was a sales promotion going on at work. I would get a bonus, and then we could buy it. Well, the end of the promotion came, but my sales did not, and I did not get the extra money. Great. What then? I needed to be able to write papers and had no software to do it with. I called up a friend of mine who worked in tech and asked him if he had a copy of Microsoft Office that he could install on my computer, knowing that I was asking him to cheat a little bit. Instead of just driving over to my house with a disk, he said, "Why don't you try OpenOffice? It's open source and you can get it for free." Open source? I had heard that term before in an article about this thing called Linux, but I wasn't familiar with using anything released under an open source license. I went to the OpenOffice website, read a little bit about it, downloaded the program, and hoped for the best. And my eyes were opened. This program, even in its early version, was great. I could write papers. I could make slideshows. I could complete classwork. It was just what I needed, and programmers out there somewhere had collaborated together to make it and give it away so folks like me could use it. This was truly transformative technology because it could help people with limited resources get what they needed. While I was attending school, I continued to use OpenOffice and they continued to improve the program. I would even take the download files and burn them to CDs so I could give them to people who needed software. This open source idea was amazing. I could get good software from people who are making it because they wanted to share their ideas and their code. I didn't have to pirate software or go to Bill Gates with my hand out like Oliver Twist saying, "Please, sir, I want some more." I was hooked. Later, I started to use Linux, and it became a hobby until I saw that the versions I used had gotten good enough to become my, and I had learned enough about using them for Linux to become my daily driver. Then I made a point of doing as much of my teacher work as possible using Linux rather than Windows, my school computer or my school issued me. To me, the idea of a school using open source software was a no-brainer. No school has unlimited money. Linux was free. It could help you get more life out of older computers. Why wouldn't they use it? What I found was that there's a huge gulf between the world of open source and the world of public education. You're all familiar with Venn diagrams, right? Two overlapping circles, compare and contrast. This slide represents a Venn diagram showing the relationship between open source and public education. As you can see, the circles do not overlap. They don't even touch. They just sit there next to each other, having no relationship at all. These worlds have absolutely nothing to do with each other. This never made sense to me. Why is this? It's not like schools and students don't need technology. They do. It's not like open source can't help schools with great solutions. It can. We can discuss a bunch of reasons, but the end result is that the gulf exists and there are very few exceptions. But the idea of open collaboration and sharing with everybody stuck with me. Open source had helped me. What about other people? I wasn't a coder, but I could take what I learned about open source and use it to help others, couldn't I? Could I? The answer was yes. Since I was a teacher, the most logical place to start was at school. I founded the first two Linux clubs in Minnesota, the Community School of Excellence Asian Penguins and the Aspen Academy Penguin Corps. Both programs started from kids having fun, learning something new, and both ended up using open source to help people. First, the Asian Penguins at Community School of Excellence in St. Paul. They were the start of an experiment. Get open source software, get used computers, have kids do the work, and see what happens. The results of the experiment are in. This works. Having kids using open source software in school helps the kids, helps the school, and helps the community. The Asian Penguins started in 2011 when I got some Linux desktop computers for my classroom. My students loved the computers and started coming to my room after school to use them. The kids were Asian, mascot of Linux was a penguin, and so the Asian Penguins was born. The five or six kids who started became a movement that eventually included over 250 student members over 8 years, with the club impacting hundreds more by recycling and giving away computers. In 2019, I came to Aspen Academy and continued the experiment. I had said any school could do this, so now was my time to prove it. I started a new club to learn about open source. The Penguin Corps started with 14 students, and at last count, we are at almost 50, and we have impacted hundreds more by refurbishing old computers for students. The way it works is this: open source software plus used computers plus enthusiastic kids equals more students learn. And it all started from a pretty simple idea. Get kids using open source and see what happens. Now it's time to let the kids tell the story. Thank you very much. Up first from the students is Michael Atkinson.